Good evening, friends. I welcome you all for the very first lecture of 2013. My name is Dr. Ghazala Shaikh. I am a Unani consultant. And today I would like to have a detailed description about my career in Unanipathy. I graduated from Mumbai's only Unani Medical College, that is Tibia College, located at Andheri, Versova. Luckily I got the chance to work as a consultant in one of the world's largest manufacturer of Unani medicine, that is Hamdard Work Lab. And during this period, I got a very good exposure. I got a chance to present Unani medicine on various national and international conferences where I spoke about various concepts of Unani medicine. And at last, I would like to share with you all that's one of my goal of life, that is to make people of the world aware of this amazing health wisdom. Now, this statement is based on very interesting facts. Unani medicine is really amazing herbal wisdom, because it traces its medical armamentarium from ancient Babylonian temples, Egyptian pyramids, Greek philosophical moorings, Roman experimentations, and Arabic and Indian medieval practices. Though the system was originated in the Western world, it has assimilated the best of Eastern wisdom as well. And that is reflected in almost all its concepts, its understanding of human body, the various concepts related with diseases, the various treatment modalities, and of course, the herbal remedies. So today, I'm going to give you some idea about kitchen remedies of Unani medicine. That's very interesting. And here what I have given you is derived from a very authentic source, that is a book published by CCRUM. CCRUM is Central Council of Research in Unani Medicine, which is one of the body under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, New Delhi. This body has published a book which is called as Common Remedies of Unani Medicine. Basically, it is for the rural India people, and it has been published in almost all Indian regional languages. As all of you know that our healthcare delivery system is not so efficient, especially in the rural areas. So all these herbal remedies play a very important role in those villages and small towns where still Western medicine is too expensive and they cannot afford it. Although the pharmaceutical companies don't want us to believe that we can live without, you know, that chemical drugs. So there are a number of OTC, which is, OTC is over-the-counter medicines. We all in cities, we all use these OTCs, but today I'm going to introduce to you some remedies, some OTC, which I can call, which is directly coming from your kitchen, which is very effective and it is very cheap also. I'll start from the body part, starting from the head. There are two kinds of ailment. Ailment can be just a simple symptoms, or maybe a temporary situation of your body where it's all is not going well. It is some kind of discomfort. How you define ailment? Ailment is very different from disease. Can you differentiate any one of you? Ailment and disease, what is the difference? In Unani medicine, we say it marz, that is disease, and arz is what is ailment. Ailment are just the discomfort when you are not following, or you are, if you have violated the natural law of your body, then your body suffers for a temporary period of time. So that time you can use any, you know, as a first aid, any medication or OTC available in the shops. And second, sometimes these ailments are a signal or a symptoms which is given by the body so as to make you realize that something going wrong, or there is one disease process which has already started in your body. So you must need to differentiate between the ailment and the disease. So I'll start first with headache, which is very common. Now there are number of causes for which you can get headache. But the most simple one, and which is documented in our CCRUM book of home remedies, is take 1 gram of mustard seed, rye, 8 gram. You have to make a paste with water. 25 ml water ke saath aapko uska ek paste banana hai. You have to dissolve it very well. Usko strain karna hai, strain it, and use just 2 drops as a nasal drop. So it will give you a temporary relief of headache. Beside it, there is also you can use aromatherapy, itre gulab. We use that rose essence as a inhalation therapy, and that also help you to ease the headache. Then come giddiness or dizziness. Now there are again number of causes. The most recommended kitchen remedies is, nowadays everybody has gooseberry, that is called amla. In some Unani shop you will find amla, murabba of amla. There are various kinds of murabbas, adrak ka murabba, sab, and these kinds of fruits are all into, you can get it in murabba form.
In variety it is called morawada sab.
Yeah, it is made with sugar syrup and yes, yes, that same in Urdu it is called murabba. So you have to take 1 piece of amla murabba, wrap it in silver foil and have it, an empty stomach. So that will help you to fight this giddiness. And if this is because of acidity, it is associated with symptom of acidity, the giddiness, then you can soak some imli, tamarind in water for 1 hour and strain the water, add some sugar and have it as a drink. This will also help you to reduce the acidity, that is the more heat in the body, and help you in getting rid of the giddiness as well. In rural India, people, you know, walk a lot in sun. So in that case, they are using this kind of therapy. I think there is one very famous recipe which I would like to share right now here, because nowadays it is getting too hotter. So you can have kairi, that is unripe mango, and you have to make, you have to take it into, you have to boil it. And you have to take out all the pulp and add some sugar, and that is called, that is a very famous drink. I think it's, you know, it's called panna in Marathi. Yes, yes, yes. It's very widely used in northern India as a remedy for having, you know, that loo. Yeah, sunstroke. Yeah, for it is a very good drink for sunstroke. So this also helps. Then comes the common cold or running nose. For this, it is given in the book. You have to wheat husk 6 gram. Gehun ki jo bhusi hoti hai. When you soak wheat and just usko agar aap ek grind karte hai, to usme se ek husk nikalta hai. That is called gehun ki bhusi. You have to take it 6 gram. Black pepper 5. And salt 1 gram. Boil the above ingredients in 120 ml of water, and you have to take this drink twice a day, and that helps in reducing the symptoms of common cold. Another very simple is cinnamon. Take 3 grams of it, boil in a water. That will be a cinnamon tea basically. And add honey and drink it twice. Then very common symptoms of the stress, that is sleeplessness or insomnia. The kitchen remedy for this is khashkhash or poppy seed. Take some poppy seeds and make a good paste of it with water. You have to boil it in one hot boil it in milk and have this drink at bedtime. So this will also help you to induce sleep. And the second is halwa badam. This is basically badam powder is prepared with other spices and ghee and sugar, and you have to take it as a breakfast, 15 grams in breakfast. Then comes conjunctivitis. In summer season we are more prone for getting this kind of infections in eye. For this, take phitkiri, that is alum, 3 grams, and dissolve, make a powder of alum and dissolve it in 60 ml of rose water and store it in a clean glass jar. And you can use it as a eye drop for fighting this conjunctivitis infection. Then it is sty. Many people suffer from this. There is one small boil either here, upper or lower eyelid. You can get a small boil there. The simple remedy is long claw. Take one claw and make a very fine paste of it with water and use it as a local application thrice a day. The sty will ultimately dissolve. Or the second remedy is date. All of you know the date. There is one seed which is very hard. Yeah, you can make a powder of or paste of it, that seed, and apply on the sty twice daily. That will also help you to get rid of the sty. Then come pain in the ear. Sometimes the children get this because of cold. So the simple remedy is you have to take 3 garlic and burn the garlic in sesame oil, strain it and use it as a ear drop. In case of emergency, you can just lukewarm it and then use it. Then come epistaxis. Now the simple is dissolve a little mustard oil in water and you have to take it as a snuff. And the second is the clay, which is very cool. You have to apply that paste on the forehead. Then mouth ulcer. This is also very common ailment. After you got some major infection on when you are recovering from many chronic fever and all, because of the low immunity, you get mouth ulcer. It is one of the sign of having deficient vitamin B also. So for this condition, you can use coconut oil as a mouth paint thrice daily. And the second remedy is take some isopgol in a small cloth, soak it in water and apply it to the affected ulcer. That will also helps to reduce the ulcer, inflammation and burning. Then halitosis, that is foul smell from the mouth. Some people suffers from halitosis because they don't have good digestion or they don't have proper dental hygiene. These are 2-3 causes of having halitosis. Now the best way is to have Ark Limu, that is available in the market, or you can take lemon juice also and dissolve it in 120 ml of water, mix it thoroughly and use it as a gargle thrice daily. So that also helps to reduce halitosis. Then there is one similar condition called pyrrhea. For pyrrhea, you can take salt and ginger. Take some ginger juice and add rock salt or common salt to that juice and apply on the gums twice or thrice daily. And the second one is longka tail claw oil. You can use as a massage on the gum and decayed tooth for quick pain relief. Then the condition which is very common in children is pharyngitis or tonsillitis. For that, you can use boiled mustard seeds, 12 grams, and vinegar, that is 35 ml, in 250 ml of water. And when it is boiled, you can use add honey into it. And this is the gargle. The child has to use this mixture as a gargle thrice daily. Then hoarseness of voice, sometimes because of over exertion of some people shout, or some people has to continuously talk for a longer period, they are having this kind of problem. Their voice gets very hoarse. For that, you can use kebab chini. Now kebab chini is one type of spices which is used, but it's look like kali mirch. But it has had a small delicate stalk with it. It's like this. Dekha aap logo ne spices mein, that is called kebab chini. Yeah, this kebab chini 1 gram with honey 6 gram. It's used as a chutney. Aap uski ek, haan, yes, yeah, kebab chini aur honey ka aap ek में चटनी बना सकते हैं. कबाब चीनी के पाउडर को यू हैव टू डिसॉल्व इट इन हनी एंड टेक इट एज अ चटनी फॉर हैविंग गुड वॉइस. सेकंड इज जौ, दैट इज बार्ली, 12 ग्राम्स. यू हैव टू ड्राई, उसको आप रोस्ट कर लीजिए, भून लेते, जिसको हम भूनना बोलते हैं, उसको ड्राई रोस्ट करना है बार्ली को. And you have to chew it simply. So that also helps to reduce the harshness of voice. Then come cough. Now it's my mother's trusted formula. It is ginger juice and honey. 12 ml of ginger juice and 12 grams of honey. You use thrice daily, or you can make a very good halwa of adrak, which is very easy. You have to make a good paste of ginger and burn some desi ghee and just roast that ginger paste in that and add some jaggery, and it become a very delicious adrak halwa. And the children can use it, that halwa, thrice or four times a day as a lozenges also, and that give excellent relief in cough. And the second remedy is also very simple. You need pure ghee, that is desi ghee, and take some 7 or 8 claws, that is long, and burn that claws in 1 teaspoon of pure ghee, add some rock salt to it, that, and you can lick it as a chutney, and this also helps to reduce the dry cough. Especially for the dry cough, claw is very useful. Now in asthmatic people, they are having chronic cough. For that, you can have abe adrak, that is available in the market. You can use it 1 teaspoon of that lukewarm. And second is buds of neem, 12 gram. It's difficult to obtain it here, but it's written in the book. You have to take one earthen pot and boil it with 120 ml of water, that buds of neem, and use it lukewarm bedtime. It's very useful for asthma patients. Then come palpitation, that may be associated with anxiety. Now the remedy for this is coriander seed, jo hum dhaniya masale mein istemal karte hain, that you have to take 6 gram. And raisin kishmish jo hai wo 10 grams. You have to soak it overnight in 60 ml of water, and in morning you make a shake of it and drink. So that helps to reduce anxiety and palpitation. And at last, I wish you all a very happy and healthy 2013 from Zara Unani Cares.in. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, any